As a kid, I was often forgetful. I'd forget even my shoes and my flip-flops, which was especially troubling to me when I was going to the pool, because you'd get out of your car and then you'd have to make it across the scalding hot pavement. I would try as much as possible to walk on those white strips between the parking spots, but inevitably I'd end up hopping around like a cartoon character all across the hot pavement. What's going on there? Where did that heat come from? Well, you probably know it came from the sun, but let's actually track it as it's transferred. First of all, in the sun, there's tons and tons of nuclear fusion reactions going on nonstop, producing tons of heat and light. And it's that light, of course, which travels all the way to the Earth. When heat is transferred by light, we call that radiation. This lesson is going to be all about heat transfer. Anyway, the pavement warms up from the radiation, and then it directly conducts that heat to my feet. I'm walking right on that pavement and it transfers right to them. Thinking about all of these different types of heat transfer is really important, and that's exactly what we're going to learn in this lesson. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll learn the three ways heat is transferred. Then we'll consider why heat is transferred. And lastly, we'll learn to identify thermal equilibrium. Let's get started on those ways heat is transferred. Probably the most common way to think about heat transfer is shown here. The warm surface is transferring heat to the ice cube through direct contact. The surfaces are just directly touching each other. We call this sort of heat transfer conduction. Conduction is heat transferred by direct contact. Another way to transfer heat is radiation, which is just a fancy name for light in this context. The electric stove is getting hot, and as it gets hot, it begins to glow. Now, you could warm something by placing it directly on that hot stove, but it's warming the room around it by the light coming off the stove. That light comes off the stove and warms the surroundings. We call this light radiation. And radiation is heat transferred by light. All right, the last way of transferring heat is shown here. What's going on? The heat is rising from the fire to the hot dogs in currents of air. It's being heated not directly, like in conduction, or by light, as in radiation, but instead it's being heated by the hot air that moves from the fire to the hot dogs. This is called convection. Convection is heat transferred by currents in a substance. So, for example, take breezes. They're a good example of this convection. Here we have a cold sea, and there's a breeze coming off of it to the warm land. Or you might have a breeze coming from the warm land to the cool sea. And this temperature change brought about by the breezes is a form of convection. You'll also notice here something interesting. The hot air from the land is going to transfer to the sea. And that's actually the way heat transfer always works. Heat is always transferred from hot to cold. Let's take a look at this at a microscopic scale. Here we see a bunch of hot atoms in red, and those large arrows mean they're moving around really quickly. In the blue, we see cold atoms or molecules, and the short arrows mean they're moving pretty slow. So in hotter objects, molecules move faster. Okay, cool. What does that mean? Well, that means that as they are brought into contact one way or another, the hot atoms transfer their energy to the cold atoms through collisions. Take a look at that purple region, where the blue and red meet. The fast-moving red atoms will collide with the slow-moving blue atoms and speed them up. Eventually, they'll approach the same speed. Let's look at another analogy. Here, imagine the white cue ball represents the hot molecules, and the others represent the cold molecules sitting still, or at least moving slower. The hot molecule comes racing in, and when they collide, the still ones start moving, and the white ball slows down. They approach similar speeds. That's what molecules in contact do. Molecules in contact approach the same speed. So, for example, say we have heat flowing from something that's 100 degrees to something that's 0 degrees. As time goes on, what's going to happen? Well, the cold is going to warm up, and the hot is going to cool down until they're both 50 degrees Celsius. We call this thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium is when two objects in contact reach the same temperature. Let's put this into practice. Let's actually start to use this language we've been developing. Here, we're going to match each description to the correct word listed below that we've been talking about. Pause the video and see if you can do this. All right, were you able to get it? For A, the asphalt warms up due to the light of the sun. We saw this example in our intro. That turns out to be radiation. The light is warming up the asphalt. The asphalt warms up your bare feet as you walk. Well, now we're in direct contact, so that's going to be conduction. C is your feet reach the same temperature as the asphalt. Well, if they're the same temperature, first of all, those are some hot toes. Second of all, that's going to be thermal equilibrium when they're the same temperature. D is a hot wind blows in from the desert. Okay, well, that's going to be transferring of thermal energy by convection, where there's a substance moving from a hot area to a cold area. All right, E is boiling water warms noodles in a pot. What is this one? Well, the water is actually hot, directly touching the cold thing, which is the noodles. So this is maybe the trickiest one, but that's conduction because we're talking about the water warming the noodles. Let's review what we've learned. First, we learned the three ways heat is transferred. We saw that heat could be transferred by conduction, that is direct contact, or by radiation, which is through light, or lastly by convection, which is through the motion of currents. Then we considered why heat is transferred. There we learned that if you look at the subatomic picture of matter as heat is transferred, it's always going to move from hot to cold because it's just simply the transfer of kinetic energy from those fast molecules, which are hot, to the cold molecules, which are moving quite slow. Then we learned to identify thermal equilibrium, which occurs when objects reach the same temperature. Hey, hey.